All right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. So I kind of wanted to switch gears here and go back to talking about wrestling in this video. So I want to talk about a wrestler by the name of Kofi Kingston. A lot of you guys may be familiar with him. He is a member of the New Day, and he has been with the WWE for what feels like decades. But he's actually only been with them since about 2006, so a little bit over one decade he's been with the WWE. So Kofi Kingston, obviously the elephant in the room here would be Kofi Kingston's chest. He has a distinct gap in his chest. And one of the reasons I wanted to make a video about this is because a lot of people have been asking me about this in DMs on Instagram, direct messages on YouTube. And the reason they asked me about this, obviously, is because I brought to light the Scott Steiner situation. So Scott Steiner had a similar issue with his chest, but I believe they are not the same issue. So with Scott Steiner, if you guys remember, what we saw in the pictures with Scott is a distinct gradual separation of his pecs. And this is something that I believe was based in the musculature of his pec. So this is not something that I believe was pectus excavatum, which I think is the case with Kofi Kingston, but we'll get to that in a minute. So Scott Steiner, as you can see in the beginning of his career, he had pretty much a perfect chest, a normal chest, a very bodybuilder-esque round and full chest that was clearly connected in the center. There was never at any point in the early days of his career any type of gap, whether it was distinct or just subtle, in his pecs whatsoever. So for Scott Steiner, the theory that was thrown forth was really the theory of micro trauma to the chest, damaging the nerves in the chest and, you know, gradually shortening the length of the muscle itself and causing this gap in between the pecs. So if you actually consider all the things that wrestlers put their body through, micro trauma actually wouldn't be that far off of a good guess. The things that they put their body through on a frequent daily basis, weekly basis, just constant, you know, doing flips, running into other, you know, wrestlers, getting chopped in the chest week after week, day after day, year after year, that could definitely add up to some sort of nerve damage that could end up in this micro trauma situation where it would cause the actual musculature of the chest to shorten or create a gap in between it where the nerve damage has happened. So with Kofi Kingston, I feel like this is not the case. So if you look at pictures of Kofi very early on in his career, he has always had a very distinct gap in between both of his pecs. There's been periods in his career where his pecs looked bigger, so the gap didn't actually look as bad. But as he's gotten older, his pecs have gotten smaller. The actual musculature of his pecs have gotten smaller than when he was a lot younger. So a lot of people will message me and say it looks like recently the situation with his chest has gotten worse. And I don't think it's that the gap itself is getting bigger. I just think the pecs are getting smaller and it's making the gap more pronounced because now that he doesn't have these, you know, bigger pecs to kind of offset this gap, now we're just seeing more gap and less pecs, if that makes sense. So I actually came across an interview with Kofi Kingston where he's talking about his chest. He's kind of, you know, laughing about it and admitting, yeah, he has this issue with his chest. And in that interview, he says that he has a concave sternum. So this is what many people suggested was the issue with Scott Steiner, but I disagree with that. So a concave sternum is pretty much pectus excavatum, which is something people can either be born with or something that can gradually progress over time throughout adolescence. So because in that interview where Kofi Kingston is talking about his chest, he specifically admits to having a concave sternum. That is the direct symptom of having pectus excavatum. And that's not something that Scott Steiner has ever addressed or admitted to, or really something that I see with Scott Steiner. It doesn't look like it's a bone issue with Scott. So other names for pectus excavatum might be cobbler's chest, funnel chest, or simply sunken chest. So I believe Kofi Kingston has a medical condition. I don't believe it's any sort of injury related to wrestling. I think it's something that he's been born with, but as he's gotten older, just the muscular development of his pecs has gotten smaller and smaller, and that gap just seems to be more and more prominent because of the size of his pecs gradually getting smaller. So that's all I think it is. I don't think it's any crazy injury or anything like that. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. What do you believe is the cause of Kofi Kingston's chest to have that severe gap in the middle? Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Nick Strength and Power, signing out.